Hello, I'm Florian Larraz, and I'm going to introduce you a study dealing with the power of the dose response framework to uncover molecular functional responses of microorganisms to chemicals. Since last decade, the rising of functional molecular approaches, such as transcriptomics, proteomics, and metabolomics, have opened new perspectives in microbial ecotoxicology. Those approaches answer to the question, what are doing or potentially doing the organisms? It deeply supports the investigation of chemical effects and the function performed by the biological compartment. But most of the studies dealing with this functional omics investigate the responses between one control or one and a few concentrations of chemicals. Such design is appropriate to investigate upstream versus downstream conditions or to assess environmental concentration effects. But it really does not support the investigation of items, trend response, repercussion across level, and threshold setting like ECX or BMD. However, the dose response framework is absolutely dealing with this aspect. To set the basis, I'm going to briefly introduce the dose response framework. So it consists in the exposure of a biological sample. It could be a population or community, to an increasing gradient of chemical concentration. After a certain time of exposure to the chemical, a biological parameter is measured to assess the effect of this chemical, and generally that could be the growth or the mortality or the photosynthesis, depending on the biological organisms. And if such approach is routinely used in ecotoxicology, the current tools to build dose response curve and derive sensitivity thresholds like EC50 are really not appropriate to molecular data. For example, they really need a specific and dedicated tools. So molecular data, usually they provide up to millions of items. So for example, responses for hundreds of metabolites of millions of contigs. And it needs to be automatized. Nobody can check one by one the responses. Then, so we have different nature of omic data. For example, with metabolomic data, we can have array under the curve, while for transcriptomic, we can have read counts or fluorescence. And that needs specific management. Finally, they provide complex responses. And part of them are biphasic, meaning with U-shape or bell shape. And this is not handled with a Hill model, which is usually used for such design. So in response to this need, we developed the Dromics tool. And briefly, this tool aims to manage molecular data obtained in the dose response framework. First, it detects which molecular items significantly respond along the dose gradient. Second, it models their response and provides a trend. Third, it derives a sensitivity threshold. So here we choose to work with the benchmark dose because it was recommended by the EFSA for molecular data. For the moment, so the tool handles transcriptomics data with microarray or RNA-seq and metabolomics data. But soon it will also handle proteomics data. And as we are also interacting all levels together, Dromics is now also able to handle apical data. So here the idea is to have one tool able to deal with different biological response levels. And we have developed this tool because we are interested in the study of the repercussion of biocide effects over biological levels. So I will show you the results of a recent study where we use this framework and this tool to better understand triclosan mode of action and the microalgae Cnidismus vacuolatus. So briefly, triclosan is commonly used to inhibit bacterial activity, but its mode of action is also susceptible to impair microalgae. And if you want some more detail, you can have a look to our two recent publications in Journal of Hazardous Material and ESNT. So first, a population was exposed to 6 concentrations of triclosan in replicates, so 5 replicates, and that during 14 hours. Then, after 14 hours, the photosynthesis, the growth, the metabolome, and the transcriptome response were assessed. And at the end, we obtained a classical dataset for apical endpoints, but also the responses of more than 60,000 probes and of 224 metabolites. Then, we imported both apical and molecular data in Dromix for downstream analysis. At the beginning of the analysis, so we imported the response of more than 60,000 probes, 224 metabolites, and two apical endpoints. Then, the significantly responding probes, metabolites, and apical endpoints over the concentration gradients were identified by the tool, and it detected 7,865 probes, 82 metabolites, and two apical endpoints as significantly responsive to the gradients of triclosan. Then it selected the best model for each probe, metabolite, and endpoint, of course, when possible. So here it's an example of some responses handled by the tool, and it is worth to say that 39% of the metabolites and 32% of the probes exhibited a biphasic response trend. So here clearly it's not an exception. This biphasic trends are really present in molecular responses, and we really need dedicated tool for that which consider such responses. And finally, the tool have derived a sensitivity value, so a BND, for 6,361 probes, 68 metabolites, and the two apical endpoints. Because several probes of this microarray were related to a same quantig, we have decided from here to work at the quantig level. And finally, so this step was made out from Dromix. Dromix only handled the previous steps. So the annotation of the item was done only based on classical bioinformatics pipeline, and it was possible to get a keg annotation for 443 quantics and 31 metabolites. So briefly, keg annotations are related to metabolic pathways. Regarding the results, first, we assess the global molecular sensitivity of the microalgae by fitting the sensitivity distribution of each quantig and metabolite selected by Dromix. On the x-axis are presented the sensitivity values, and on the y-axis are the proportion of items. In blue are the non-annotated items, and in orange the annotated one. So first, we can see that both metabolites and quantics exhibit a wide range of sensitivity, and that both distributions are really similar. Also, apical endpoints exhibited a lower sensitivity, with BMD values completely out of range. So in this case, we decided for this study to remove them from this analysis. Second, we wanted to identify which pathway was potentially impaired by triclosan. So on the x-axis are the number of quantics and metabolites responding to triclosan and involved in each pathway, presented on y-axis. So we can see that 18 pathways were identified as potentially impaired, and in most of cases at both levels. If we expected to detect the lipid metabolism as impaired due to its mode of action, it's clear that triclosan impairs a wide diversity of pathways directly and indirectly. Then, for each of these pathways, we build a sensitivity distribution of the metabolites and the quantics. Here is presented an example for lipid metabolism, as it shown the most interesting results. So again, the x-axis displays the sensitivity value of each item and the y-axis their proportion. The point shapes show the trend response, so for example, the diamond shows decreasing trend, the circle shows the bell trend, and the cross the U shape. And the color shows the strength of the response, so the strength of the signal. This figure shows that most of metabolites involved in lipid metabolism shown a decreasing response trend over the concentration gradient, while the transcriptome shown especially U-shape and increasing trend. So here we have really two biological levels, but not the same trend of response at all. And this figure let's suggest a direct effect of triclosan on lipid metabolism and at the metabolomic level. So that also supports the added value of multi-omic studies. Finally, from each of those distributions, we derive the 25 percentiles to build a pathway sensitivity distribution. So here, this figure it was made in the spirit of the species sensitivity distribution. And on the x-axis, we have the 25 percentiles, and on the y-axis, the pathways. Clearly, we see here that lipid metabolism is the pathway the most at risk at the metabolomic level. And again, we have two different omics level, but we don't have at all the same information. But anyway, we can say that all of the values remain in a small range of effect. So in conclusion, we can say that the dose response design applied to molecular responses supports clearly the trend response definition along the concentration gradient. So that means that we can highlight genes or metabolites which can cope or not with stress. Then we can also derive some sensitivity characterization of molecular items through the effect thresholds. And it clearly improves the mechanistic understanding of chemical mode of action and supports ecological risk assessment. If you are interested in the approach, I can only recommend you to check our online application, which is a turnkey tool. And if you feel brave enough to use R, I recommend you then to check also our Dromix R package. If you are also interested to join our next online training course, which will take place during the fall, please don't hesitate and write me an email at the address below. Thank you for your attention.